Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Billy Bravo Road to the Show series here in MLB 15, the show on the PS4. Now, Billy Bravo is about to make his last start in the month of August, moving on into the last month of the year, September here, of his rookie season. So the Orioles and the Rangers, you see both a season to forget for both these teams. The Rangers doing even worse. But Billy Bravo has pitched well. I mean, his ERA just above 2. He's got a lot of hard luck, if you've watched any of the series, with getting any run support. And we'll see if that's a problem again today as he takes the mound in Arlington. That's a little bunt attempt. Catcher not going to get the throw down there in time, and that's an infield bunt. Base hit for Leonis Martin. He'll be on, and Bravo will have to deal with a base runner. So an 0-2 count with one out. And Prince Fielder is going to swing and miss at the high fastball. Set him up with pitches low in the zone and then went high and got him to strike out. So now with two outs and an 0-2 count, pitching to Ryan Ludwig, who will put it in play. J.J. Hardy backhands that and throws to first. The inning is over. We'll move on to the second inning of work for Billy Bravo now. See if he gets any run support. Hey, they scored a run for him. All right, that's awesome. So he's got the 1-0 lead. Oh, a little mesmerized there. Should be covering first base. It's okay. Chris Davis makes the play on his own, stepping on first and getting the out. So now an 0-2 count with one out. Billy Bravo is going to have this one put in play on him, but it's out to right field and caught by Ichiro for out number two. That's what you want to do. Keep it in the ballpark. Make your fielders do some work for you. 2-2 count with two outs. Strike three out of the zone, and he chased it again, set up by his series of pitches, and he gets the strikeout to end the inning. Billy Bravo looking good through a couple frames here, allowing just one hit. And we will now move on to his third inning appearance. Gets back on the bump, and it will still be a 1-0 score. 0-2 count. Love would get ahead against guys here. Surprises him with a pitch up in the zone. Doesn't strike him out, but he pops it way up on the infield. And that is going to be an easy out to start the inning, as once again he's gotten the leadoff batter. Next batter, he falls behind 1-0, and that's going to be chopped in front of the plate. Catcher almost could have tagged the runner. Instead, he throws down to first and gets the out. That's out number two on the inning. Let's see if he can finish it off here. 1-2-3, the 1-0 count. Elvis Andrews going to get a base hit to left field. So, no, he cannot get it. 1-2-3. He'll have to pitch to another batter in this inning, and we'll see how that affects Billy in trying to close this inning down. 2-2 count with two outs, and the pitch is going to be strike three again, fooling him with a pitch just outside of the zone, and it will end the inning with a strikeout. We go to the fourth inning, and Prince Fielder back up again. He's striking out for the second time. Okay. Every time you can set a power hitter like that down, you feel good about it. 1-2 count to Ludwig. That is going to be strike three, high in the zone. Set him up with low pitches, then went high for the strikeout pitch. Bravo working those three pitches. We've been thinking about adding a fourth pitch. We'll get to that a little later and what we're thinking about that. This ball's lined to left, but it should be an out, and it is. Delman Young takes care of that, and the inning is over. Bravo still staked to that 1-0 lead, and he is doing well. You see, only one hit for the Orioles. It was a home run to this point that got him the lead. Brian Dozier makes a nice diving play right there and throws him out from his knees. Yeah, you know Bravo will be appreciative of the defensive effort right there. They brought Brian Dozier over, partly for his bat, but partly for fielding like this as well. So a nice play there gets them the first out of the fifth. 1-2 count and strike three. Another strikeout for Bravo as he is kind of cruising along right now. I think he's just thrilled to be on the right side of a 1-0 score right now. I mean, he's not expecting bunches of runs. I mean, the one is nice right now. That slap to left for a base hit could be problematic here as you now have a runner starting off the inning. Okay, let's see how he responds to this. First pitch to the next batter is going to be lined to center field, and you've got back-to-back hits now. Runner going to stay at second base, but you've got a threat with first and second and nobody out. And here's where you get a little nervous, just having that 1-0 lead. He knows it's always very little room for error. He gets the strikeout right there and does finish off the inning strong. There you go. So he strands two runners and completes the fifth inning still with the 1-0 lead, just having given up, well, four hits here. He'll carry into the bottom of the sixth with his pitch count at 70, and there's strike three. The changeup mesmerized him. No swing to offer at that thing. He is caught looking at strike three. So now with a 2-2 count to Prince Fielder, finally puts a ball in play. He's not going to strike out this time, but it's going to stay in the yard, and that's all that matters to Billy, as that is caught for out number two on the inning. Adam Jones makes a catch, and here we go trying to get out of this. 0-1 to Ludwig. He's going to put it in play. That is not going to be caught. That's going to split the outfielders. Bravo realizes he probably should back up third base right here. He's going to stop with a double, but this is trouble right now for Bravo, as he's got another runner in scoring position in the way of Ryan Ludwig. So let's see if he can strand him out there. 1-0 count. This is put in play to Chris Davis. Steps on the bag, and the inning is over. So Bravo's done it again. Stranded a runner and kept the goose egg on the board. Into the seventh. Now 83 pitches strong. This is going to be rolled to J.J. Hardy. No problem getting that out. Out number one of the inning. How long will Showalter go with him here in the lead, knowing that, they're probably not going to get any more runs on the board? This is off Billy Bravo's leg, trying to find the ball. When he does, it's too late to get the runner. Question is Billy Bravo okay? That's what Showalter wants to know. That's what his catcher wants to know. Everybody wants to know if Billy Bravo can stay out there. He says he's fine. He shakes him off, but Showalter says, I think it's time for your effort to be done for the night anyway. So he hits the showers here with the 1-0 lead, responsible for the runner at first base. And wouldn't you know, that runner comes around to score. He's now got a no decision. Baltimore does get the lead back at 2-1 and will actually win the game. But hard luck again for Billy Bravo, going 6 1/3, only allowing one run. And he takes the no decision. Yeah, he deserves better than that. He really does. Another quality start, but that record remains at 6-8. And that ERA at 2.14. Man, oh man, he deserves more wins than that, I tell you. But he's got to put all that aside. It is what it is. He's just not playing on a team that scores a lot of runs this year. That's evident by a 56-77 record. So he gets a little spotlight here for his last month's effort. Somehow, I don't know, was he 1-0? I'm not sure if that's true. Maybe all the no decisions and then finally a win. Maybe that is true. But anyway, that's what he's dealing with here coming in to this game against Toronto. And yeah, think of a lineup, at least in real life, that you would not want to pitch against. It'd be the Toronto Blue Jays. They are just murdering teams with their bats right now. Donaldson and Bautista and Encarnacion, and it just keeps going and going. But he does register a strikeout here. Luckily, this team isn't quite as stacked as the real life team. They don't have Tulowitzki, at least. Forgot Tulowitzki. The names go on, and that team is just amazing right now. That ball is in the gap, and it looks like extra bases. Billy Bravo going to cover in case the throw is bad. He's going to try to stretch this to three. The throw is in time to get him. A little bit greedy going for three, and he will be thrown out. Adam Jones gets this ball in here to the relay, and that's Dozier, I believe, making the throw to third base to get him. So they get a little lucky right there to pick him off going to third base. For some reason, I cannot throw a strike to Jose Bautista. It's like I'm trying to throw it right down the middle half the time just to avoid a walk, and I still couldn't do it. But whatever. He recovers and gets the strikeout against Encarnacion, probably the hottest hitter in baseball right now in real life. Okay, so we go on to the second inning, no score. Josh Donaldson. Well, it's not a home run. I guess we can feel good about that, but he does single the right field and start the Blue Jays inning. Let's see if this turns into any big threat for the Jays. Russell Martin at the plate, and he's going to single up the middle sharply. Runners at first and second for Bravo to worry about now. Okay, he's going to really have to hunker down with nobody out. 1-1 pitch, and that's put in play. Oh, did he get a double play? He could really use one right now, and he gets it. Double play ball, and just like that, he gets two outs. There is a runner at third base. But yeah, this is where he wants to be, facing Danny Valencia. 1-1 count, and whoops, the breaking pitch is hammered. And of all people in that lineup I was going to be worried about, it wasn't Danny Valencia, but yet there he is, hitting a two-run homer to left and spoiling the inning. Right there, he gets a charge into it. Bravo knows right there that ball is not coming back. So 2-0 Blue Jays. And we move on to the bottom of the third. Now two runners on for Donaldson. Lines this to right field, but it's going to stay up for Ichiro to make the play, and the inning is over. It remains at 2-0 despite more trouble. The Orioles come back and tie this thing in the top of the fourth, giving new life to Billy Bravo out on the mound. This is a little chopper. Is Bravo going to field it? No, catcher takes it and makes the play. Okay, as long as we get the out, I don't care who deals with it. We have 2-2 count in the fifth with two outs, and that's going to be grounded to Dozier for the out. So Bravo settling down into a rhythm here now after the Valencia homer, keeping his team even. We go now to the sixth inning and two outs and an 0-2 count, and Donaldson will chop that one to third base. No problem. They get the out, and the inning is over. Game remains a 2-2 score. Will he come back out for the seventh inning? The pitch count's kind of high. They've worked him for long at-bats. He does not. The Blue Jays win this. It's another no decision for Billy Bravo. He goes six innings, giving up two earned runs. But you know what? It's another quality start, and he kept his team in it. It's not his fault they didn't win the thing. But he remains at 6-8, and the ERA just slightly bumps up there to 2.18. Still awesome. But that's where we're going to leave off for this episode. He's going to the Bronx to take on the Yankees next. Should be interesting. Bravo versus Michael Pineda at Yankee Stadium when we come back for more Billy Bravo. Leave a like, and we will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!